Never knows how you come across somebody once in a while you shouldn't have messed with. That's me. Well,
I won't back down. I am not an African American.
You're Oreo cookie, white on the inside and black on the outside.
I don't have an Afro, I have an Amerifro.
Talking that idiotic stuff you talk about, I will slap you.
Go ahead, make my day.
Black as the ace of spades, but 100% American.
Heard around the world by everybody and their mama. The Jesse Lee Peterson Radio Show.
Uniting the races with truth instead of dividing them with lies. We also rebuilding the family by rebuilding the man. Welcome to the show. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Thank you so much for being with me. You can get involved by calling 888-775-3773. 888-77-JESSE. Jam-packed show for you today. Happy Valentine's, all you folks out there who are in love or thinking about falling in love one day. Happy Valentine's, ladies. I have with me Leil Lowndes. She is internationally recognized communication expert who specializes in subconscious interaction and subliminal approaches that unknowingly take place in all interpersonal communications. And she's the author of 10 books. We're going to tell you how to get her books before she leaves the airways this morning, including the top-selling How to Talk to Anyone and How to Make Anyone Fall in Love with You. I wanted to talk to her about her brand new book, How to Create Chemistry with Anyone. And let's bring her in here. Leil, good morning and welcome to the show.
Oh, good morning, Jesse. I'm so happy to be with you this morning.
Thank you. Happy Valentine's.
Happy Valentine's Day to you, yours, and to all of your wonderful listeners, too.
Thank you. Is Valentine's Day just for women, or is it for men, too?
Well, you know, I think that women are a lot more excited about it because one of the things that women most need to hear from a man, it's evolutionary-based. In the Cro-Magnon days, we needed the love of a man if we wanted to survive, and evolutionary forces hold on pretty tight.
Yeah.
And so we want most of all to hear that I love you, I care for you, I want to protect you and be with you forever. But a lot of men just don't know how to say that, so they give flowers and candies. So those are just symbols. But yes, I think it does mean a lot more to women because our brains are so different.
My audio engineer just told me he got up this morning, came to work, did not say Happy Valentine's to his wife.
No.
He said it's too early.
Oh, he better call her back right now.
Very interesting book, How to Create Chemistry with Anyone. How does chemistry fit into a lasting relationship?
Oh, you asked the bingo question there. There are two totally different kinds of chemicals involved in love. The first is that dopamine blast, I want to be with you forever, I die without you, type of passionate love, I want to make love to you around the clock. Now, that has a lifespan, unfortunately, of only 1.5 to 2 years, it's been proven, and it dies down, and tragically, so many couples think that that means love is ending. No, that actually is, interestingly enough, chemically, one of the times when the true love is starting to set in, because the real love chemical, oxytocin, mitigates against testosterone and can drive that dopamine craziness down. So the lasting love, there are techniques, actual techniques to create the dopamine and techniques to create the oxytocin, and the second is by far the most life-fulfilling.
Is chemistry something that we create ourselves, or is it naturally given to us by God?
It is naturally given to us, and I'll tell you why in a moment. But if you don't have those particular qualities, there are I call them little tricks, forgive me, that you can do to create them. But let me tell you naturally first. First of all, we all have what is called a love map. Now, this is formed usually between the ages of 1 and 5 when we know that, or we sense very subliminally, subconsciously, about the type of person that we could fall in love with in our life, maybe 15 or 20 years later, we see someone who looks like they could be from that same gene pool, who looks slightly like maybe our parents or our aunts or our uncles. And that gives us a familiar blast, which shoots the dopamine into what is called the pleasure center of our brain, the caudate nucleus. And also, it can be kind of a bad thing, because if, heaven forbid, you were brought up in an abusive atmosphere around, parents or people who didn't treat you well, you could feel that same blast for someone 15 or 20 years later who reminded you of that abusive person. Hmm. And that's an explanation for the bad boy syndrome to a great extent. Now, I have one other half of the answer to your very good question, and that is, yes, Mother Nature does create a spark in us. When we spot someone with whom she feels you could produce a healthy baby, Mother Nature's role in this world is to make the world flourish with the healthiest plants, animals, birds, flowers, and human beings.
Yes.
And we all have a different immune system. We all have parasites and germs in our individual immune systems. Nothing's wrong with those parasites and germs. They're just our parasites and germs. But if you meet someone who has a immune system too similar to yours, you're not going to feel sexual attraction. It's like brothers and sisters usually don't feel sexual attraction for each other.
Right.
But if you meet someone whose immune system is a perfect match with yours to produce the best baby, Mother Nature gives you a blam, dopamine spark, so that you feel that click with the person. So those two are the perfect storm.
I was thinking about this last night, taking a look at myself. I was thinking about chemistry and love. And at one point, I used to date a lot when I was younger. And the only time that I can remember, now I may remember later today, the only time that I felt chemistry or what I thought was love toward a woman was when I wanted to have sex with her as a man. So I'm thinking maybe men don't feel this chemistry that women seem to feel a lot. But the only time that I would feel it is when I wanted to have sex. And once I had sex, the chemistry and the love feeling left.
Mm-hmm.
But yet I knew I cared about the woman, you know. But I just didn't feel all that stuff that comes when you want to have sex.
Jesse, you're totally normal. That is exactly what happens. That's one of the reasons that, one of the 75 techniques in my book is to create that sexual feeling and that spark with a man, because yes, the perfect storm here is testosterone and dopamine together. So to create that, a woman can, well, let's just say you spot your target man, I call him your quarry in the book, across the crowded room, and you want to create that spark. What you do is you're dressed very conservatively. You're dressed like a woman really to be reckoned with, a good girl, I guess you'd call it. But you look at his eyes and then let your eyes ever so slowly travel down his chest, no lower than his belt buckle, but back up at his chest and give him a big approving smile. Now, what does that do? It shoots the testosterone right through the roof. I mean, a man's testosterone grows up 1/3 just talking to an attractive woman. So can you imagine what that does? And the caudate nucleus, the pleasure center in our brain, lives a lot in the future. So naturally, he's thinking future rewards, future sex with this woman. And bingo, he's feeling that same spark. It's a simulated spark. It's not the love map spark. It's not the immune system spark. But it is definitely a spark that he transfers over to you and thinking that you are absolutely the one who has created that spark.
Amazing. 888-775-3773. Quick break. Back in a moment, folks. Happy Valentine's Day to the ladies out there.
If you got leaving on your mind,
Happy Valentine's Day. I am Jesse Lee Peterson. Thank you so much for being with me. Talking to Leil Lowndes, internationally recognized communications expert, and she's written several books, 10 of them to be exact, on love and different things. Leil, you mentioned the brains of a few minutes ago, the difference between men and women. You write in your book about the difference between men and women's brains. What are the differences?
Oh, my goodness. Do you have a couple of months I could tell you? You are married to a practically neuroanatomically different species.
Yeah.
Let me just give you one example. Women are always asking men, well, how do you feel about that?
Yeah.
Or, no, it is practically a physical a big challenge for a man to even talk about his feelings for this reason, talking brain structure. Now, a woman does a lot of her thinking with the white matter in her brain. A man does a lot of thinking with the gray matter. Now, the white matter, the neurons are more closely connected, so she can make connections a lot easier than a man. And most importantly, the linguistic part of the brain is on the left side of the brain, and the emotional, the amygdala, the emotional, is on the right. Now, the man has a much thicker wall. It's called the corpus callosum that goes right down the middle, dividing the emotional and the linguistic. So for a man to jump back and forth between his feelings and his words, it's like going over the wall of China compared to going over a wall of white picket fence.
Yeah.
So everything John Gray, men are from Mars, women are from Venus, said 20 years ago is right. But the difference is they didn't have the neurological studies now. Everything in my book is based on the neurological studies referenced in the back. And so now that we know why you shouldn't do these things, it's a lot easier to remember, and you can extrapolate from that.
I notice in today's America, there's a strong effort to make men think and feel and act like women. Is that a good idea?
I think that building men's sensitivity is a good idea, and I also think that building women's way of thinking somewhat like a man, where it's the bottom line, is very good in business. The blend of the two is absolutely the best. And what I really wish is that both men and women could learn the importance of bringing back chemistry into a long-term relationship. And this would prevent a lot of divorces. The chemical, as I mentioned, of long-term love is oxytocin, and there are ways to actually create that chemical and bring back a romance into your life. Not the same dopamine crazy. In fact, dopamine is described, love is described by neurologists as an elevated activity in the brain pathways, which causes feeling of euphoria, strong motivation, heightened energy, which can induce sleeplessness, loss of appetite, and obsessive thinking about the beloved. You are not going to bring that back, no matter how much you want.
Yeah.
But you can bring in a stronger love through, well, just one technique, the power of non-sexual touch, spooning each other while you're sleeping, holding hands, a man brushing the hair off of the woman's cheek and touching her. These things actually physically create oxytocin, which induces a much longer-term type of quiet love.
Amazing. It sounds like a lot of work, though.
Work to caress your wife and to hold her. Oh no, come on! That's not work. That's lovely. And a woman's body is so much more sensitive all over. In fact, another trade deal should be made now. May I talk about quickies and longies?
Well, as long as we keep it clean here.
Of course,
okay.
It's not unclean. It's loving. A woman interprets a man's love. A man interprets a woman's love, excuse me, as giving him sex. Now, a man, just by the way his brain is formed, is able to push everything out of his mind, as everyone needs to do if they're going to enjoy sex, and be able to jump into it quickly. A woman can't do that. Her brain is so intertwined. Her neurons are zapping back and forth so much more quickly that it takes a long time for her to push everything out of her mind so that she can enjoy sex. So people worry about the sex going out of their love life. A way to bring that back is for a woman to accept Quickie. She doesn't need to lie and say that she really enjoys him. Just let him know that because she loves him so much, she likes that close quickness. And then in turn, let him know that she enjoys the long, the slowies, I call them in the book, the slowies, and that he should give her the slowies. He will do that a lot more if she doesn't turn him down for the quickies, because lots of times he's afraid to start a slowie because he's afraid he'll be turned down.
Amazing.
So, yeah, bring back the quickies and men give the slowies, and that's what will keep not the dopamine crazy kind of sex alive forever, but it sure will improve your love life and your sex life.
Is sex love?
Sex is an expression of love when the oxytocin starts to jump in. Sex at the very beginning, usually a woman needs to feel something of the oxytocin desire to bond with a man before she can thoroughly enjoy sex with him. I'm saying usually, generalizations, and a man usually can just enjoy the sex and not think about the bonding afterward.
Yeah. I've noticed with men, including myself, men only pretend that they think sex is love until after the act is over. They know that that's what women want to hear. But men don't truly think of sex as love, because
right.
if they did, they would just bond with, quote unquote, bond with one woman, and that relationship would last until death do them part. But one is never enough for most men.
Right, and this, of course, is nature's influence. Nature wants there to be as many earthlings, as many babies as there can be, and so it's up to men. I mean, she designates that men will be the ones who will produce as many babies as they can, and that women will be the ones who choose the man, because women are the real choosers. Two-thirds of all relationships are initiated by something that the woman does. So, yes, also another problem with this men and love is when a man culminates the sexual act, during that moment that he is having that experience, oxytocin rushes into his brain just for a second or two. It subsides afterward, and he's more apt to shout out, "I love you," to a woman he doesn't, and that is so unfair.
Yeah. Should a man or a woman make the opposite sex fall in love with them? Should they make that happen, or should that come naturally?
It would be lovely if it can come naturally, but it boils down to, do chemicals create the emotions in your mind, or do the emotions create the chemicals? And does it really matter? How to create chemistry with anyone does is it gives you the way to create the chemicals of both first attraction and right on through dating and for long-term love. So it is love until death do you part, not until divorce do you part.
Yeah.
And it's chemical. And so you're going at it from a totally different angle.
When I come back, when we come back, we're going to tell the folks how to get your books and to your website. 888-7753-773. Back in a moment. Love is in the air. It is Valentine's Day. I've noticed that on Valentine's Day, you go past the flower shops or candy stores, especially Seeds candy store right down the road from my office. There are like long lines of men waiting to buy candy and flowers for their wives or girlfriends. But when it's Father's Day or Men's Day or whatever day, I don't see lines anywhere. It's just empty lines, empty stores for the most part. I'm going to ask Leah, why is that? Leah, before you give out information in your book, why is there more, the men seem to be more focused on the woman's day, pretty much as Valentine's Day for the woman, than the other way around, or equally done?
Very, very interesting and good question, Jesse. It is because The woman's brain is so, well, first of all, as I mentioned before, she wants the love of a man. She needs the man of she needs the love of a man. And a man very often just is not able to express it. As we talked about, the emotional side of his brain and the linguistic side of his brain are kind of blocked compared to hers. And so he will buy flowers, he will buy other things for his wife, because he thinks that that is what she will interpret as love. And if that is the only way of really expressing his love, then it's a good idea, because she does want something.
You have 10 books you've written. Tell the folks how to get them, get to your website, and all the good stuff.
Sure, I'd be very happy, and thank you for asking. Yes, people can go to find out about my books, not buy them, but to find out about my books on my website, peoplemagnet.com. That's one word, peoplemagnet.com. And, of course, they're all on Amazon and in most of the major bookstores.
How can a couple tell when they are ready to get married?
When the first blush of passion is gone, and when they realize, I give a lot of a test of what you should have with your partner. And one is, you want to determine whether your basic core beliefs and values are the same.
Yeah.
That draws a lot of couples apart. Very important, something people hardly ever think of, are your definitions of togetherness the same? Now, maybe one partner, let's just say the woman arbitrarily, the woman thinks of a marriage as being together all the time, having the same friends, going everywhere together, whereas a man may think of it as living under the same roof, loving her, but having his own friends and going where he wants, when he wants. And it's a big surprise to couples when they find out, very tragic surprise, that they had a very, very different feeling of togetherness.
That's
you want
a good
to also
point.
Make sure they're there for you in, heaven forbid, adversity. God forbid there should be an accident or an illness. You want to make sure that that person that you are going to spend the rest of your life with has caretaking genes in them.
I recommend, and I may be wrong in this because you're the expert, that when they're dating, that they wait at least 7 years before they get married. Am I wrong in that?
You know, 2 years, I think, is the best amount of time, because that is the amount of time that Mother Nature makes it so that the dopamine, the thrill, goes down. Doing anything exciting after 2 years dies down, and loving sex even with the same person, the passion, the desire, the mania for it dies down. So, and also the dopamine blinds you to a person's real qualities. If we have time, I can give you the physical reason for that, the anatomical reason.
Yeah, give me a quick one.
Okay. Inside the brain, younger people's brains are not what they call myelinated. Myelination is like a grease tube that helps the neurons go from, well, all over the brain, but basically in this case, from the emotional part of the brain called the amygdala to the thinking part of the brain called your prefrontal cortex. And until those tubes are thoroughly connected, as they are by about the age of 25, that's the time that they're fully connected and you can make a lot clearer decisions. Up until then, your neurons are zapping all over. Before 2 years, dopamine, Mother Nature's plant, is blinding you to the real qualities of the person, because, of course, she wants you to produce another earthling. So
Amazing. Wait
until the 2 years when you feel that you can really get to know the wonderful qualities of this person, and he or she can get to know yours.
Leil Lowndes, thank you so much for coming on. Happy Valentine's Day to you. I hope you have a sweet, flowery day.
Thank you so much, Jesse, and all blessings right. to you and to all of your wonderful listeners.
All right. Now, have a good day.
Thanks.
Bye. 888-775-3773. Back in a moment.